In today's video, we're going to look at the ZEN DAC version 2. This is a high quality, high res audio DAC from iFi. The ZEN DAC has many features, including PCM from 384 up to 44.1 kHz, DSD, DXD, and a MQA decoder built in. It's quite a small and attractive form factor, perfect for sort of sitting on your desk and plugging your headphones straight in, but also has two RCA ports on the back for connecting to your amplifier or whatever, and also has two balanced outputs as well as one unbalanced output for depending on what your headphones you're going to be using, but more on that a bit later. So I've been testing the ZEN DAC with my AKG K240 studio headphones. They're not the best headphones on the market, but I use the iFi website. They have a headphone calculator tool, so you can work out whether your headphones or whatever headphones you're going to purchase will be a good fit for the DAC or device you're going to buy, which I found quite helpful. But to be honest, this particular DAC is built from 16 ohms up to 600 ohms. You know what you're looking for. Most things are going to be covered in that range, I would have thought. So I started off by downloading the latest drivers from iFi and checking that it had the latest firmware. I'd suggest you do this. It doesn't take too long, but I wouldn't use the default drivers and I'd make sure everything's up to date so you're getting the best out of your DAC when you get it. That only took a few minutes, and then I watched a quick video on how to set up the DAC with Tidal or Tidal, however you say that. And then I was straight into listening to music and hearing the full advantage of this DAC and what you get with it. So after a few minutes of setup, I was listening to music and I could already tell that this DAC was making the most out of my headphones. Enabling the true bass on the front really made a big difference for my headphones because they're open back, and it gave it that sort of warm bass feeling that you don't really get with open back headphones without a lot of tweaking, but it was just there at a push of a button. So I got a real nice crystal clear warm sound from the ZEN DAC, and I'm really impressed. The volume, I never really had it over 50%. There was always plenty there. I never felt like I needed more on the dial, and especially by enabling the power match, I never needed any more. What I will say is that the dial itself, I know this is a strange thing to comment on, it's very, very smooth and well engineered. And with that, with the LED around the outside that shows you what audio format you're listening to, just looks really nice on your desk, and I keep it within hand's reach just so you can just adjust gently while you're listening to music. So one of the more interesting things about the iFi ZEN DAC is that it has balanced outputs, which at this sort of price point is quite rare. There are other DACs that say that they will give balanced outputs at this sort of price range, but I don't know. Without testing it, I wouldn't possibly believe it. So that was really what I wanted to do. But the question was, can they really provide actual balanced output at this price point? And I set out to try and find out a way to test to prove whether they can or can't. Before I start, if anyone's going to retrace my tip, be very, very, very careful if you have a multi-channel oscilloscope. More likely than not, both of your channels have a common ground between them. So connecting grounds between the two channels could be dangerous and could damage the DAC. So you've been warned, please don't. So here's my theory. And if anyone has any suggestions on a better way to test this, please stick them in the comments below because I'd love to know about how to do that in future. But it took me a while to sort of develop this. On an unbalanced system, the circuit will change depending on how many speakers are in there and how much resistance is on the entire circuit. You add and change the amount of speakers, it will adjust accordingly, and the amp will work harder or less or reduce to provide the circuit with enough power for the total resistance in the circuit. Hopefully I'm not explaining that very badly, but it's just simple P over I times V. You add more speakers in, it's going to work harder to drive all of those speakers. But on a balanced system, you have two completely separate outputs. So in this case, we have a left and a right cup, and the balance between them is completely irrelevant because they're two completely different circuits. So what I wanted to prove is that any change to the left cup won't have any effect on the right cup, and vice versa. So I stuck my oscilloscope on one channel and then used the voltmeter to check on the other side. I didn't want to stick my oscilloscope on both for the reasons before, but I was then changing the resistance value on one side and seeing if it made any fluctuation on the other. And I did this by simply using a tone generator on my computer to have a flat tone coming out at all times, and then sticking different resistors on one channel and then seeing if there was a fluctuation in the oscilloscope on the other side. And I could clearly see when I'm changing the resistance value on the voltmeter, the circuit is compensating for it as they should, but the other channel was not fluctuating in any way, shape or form. So this proves to me that these circuits are completely separated and you have true balanced outputs coming out of the ZEN DAC. And I spent a good couple of hours deciding on how I was going to do this and testing it with different sine waves, different sound levels and different volumes, and could see no change on either channel. So I can really say that the ZEN DAC can provide true balanced output. Other than that, I've just been using my AKG K240s and I've modified them to have a balanced input. If I've completed the video on how I modified them, I'll link to it at the top of the screen. Otherwise, subscribe and that'll be coming very, very soon. So overall, this is a really good DAC for the money, especially at this price point with all the features that you get. I've been testing this on my PC and I've spent way too many evenings just testing thoroughly just by sitting and relaxing and listening to music. I have really enjoyed my time and it's really been an eye-opener how good this thing can drive a good bit of sound. I've also tested it on my phone. So I plugged in an OTG cable and plugged it straight in the back, thinking that it probably wouldn't work because something more like the iFi X-Can would be a more suitable mobile DAC, but it worked straight out of the tin. And using Tidal or Tidal on my phone allowed it to make use of the onboard MQA decoder. So I was very surprised that it would have that sort of power to do that. But yeah, straight out of the box, worked fine. So again, as we always say, we'd love to hear what you think in the comments below. If you've got any questions, throw them down there. If you've got any suggestions on how better to test this, I'd love to hear that as well. If I make any updates to how I've tested this in the future, they'll be in the blog post, which I'll link in the description. So I hope you've enjoyed it. Like and subscribe if you have, and we'll hopefully see you in the next one. Thanks a lot.